Because that way, if he actually comes and takes something away from me, His right upon me is far more greater than my rights upon him. لَإِنَّهُ قَبِلَ مِنِّي قُرْبَانًا لِلَّهِ. Because when he came to take a gift or came to take a charity, he accepted the means for me to become closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the mentality. This is how we used to think. So the question, my brother, to you is, are you from the people of this dunya or are you from the people of al-akhirah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mashallah, in Surah Al-Baqarah, elaborated on this point. And he said, فَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ. He said, some people will come and say, Ya Allah, give us in this dunya. I need a better car, job, work, money, clothing, kicks, this, that, and the other. Only all the things he asks for, a new phone, a new laptop, a new computer, all these things, right? Things to do with this dunya. But in the akhirah and the hereafter, he has no share. Why he has no share? Because why are you asking these things? Ya Allah, grant me a car so I can go to the mosque in Fajr so I can make my salah. Ya Allah, give me a laptop or a phone so I can connect with my family, have Silatul Rahim, and I can be intact with some WhatsApp groups for Islamic knowledge, and I can research about Islam and listen to Quran. Are these the reasons why you're asking Allah for these things? Ya Allah, grant me some new clothing so I can, you know, have a better way of going to the masjid and I can take care of myself with it to do with the fashion and so on. These are the questions that you need to ask yourself. So Allah is saying in the Quran, these some people, they will ask things just for this dunya, but in the akhirah, they have no share. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. And then you have other people that will say, Ya Allah, bless us in this dunya with some good reward, and bless us in the hereafter with some good reward, and keep us away from the hellfire. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ نَصِيبٌ مِمَّا كَسَبُوا وَاللَّهُ سَرِيعُ الْحِسَابِ. These people that they ask for this goodness in this world and the hereafter, they will have a share for what they ask for. And Allah is swift in His account. Look what Allah is saying. Allah is swift, He's quick in His account. So my brother, ask yourself the question. The reason why you spend all that time in university, the reason why you spend all that time at work, and you spend all that time with the boys and the brothers and the sisters, right? I mean sisters and sisters, yeah? Not brothers and sisters. All that time you spend, is it to do with what? Is it to do with increasing your deen, to make you a better Muslim? So you make sure that you're building towards the akhirah. When you leave that gathering of your brothers, do you leave the gathering knowing a new thing about Allah, about the Rasul, learning about certain manners, learning about certain things you should or shouldn't do? Is that how the gathering is always the case with you? Or is it always to do with the dunya? And this is where the ulama, when they explained, they said that the means of work or the means of study is always to sustain yourself in this dunya. That's the only reason why you do it, nothing else. The reason why you work, you go to university, you spend 12 to 16 hours studying or working, you're doing this so you can sustain yourself. You're not doing this so you can live that life. This is why the Rasul told you and told me that you have to live in this life as if you're a traveler. You're just traveling. Imagine you're traveling from Newcastle to London and you stop on every single house, every single city and town and village, every single place, farm, everywhere. You stop every single place and you're having a conversation. You're selling or buying something. You're staying over the night. How long will it take you to arrive to your destination? You might even die before you arrive to London if you're going to spend around all that gap to go all the way to London. That's not traveling. If you want to travel from A to B, you sustain yourself for you can go from A to B. Get your water, your food, or whatever, you put your fuel, you make sure that your gas is ready, your car is fine, your tires are right, and you make that journey. Actually, you want to go there quick. So it's 4 or 5 hours, you want to gas it. This is if you're a traveler. Now, compare yourself to this dunya. Is that what you're doing? How are you living your life? Making sure that you're building towards the akhirah, and you're going there on a quicker way. And this is where, alhamdulillah, one of the beautiful ulama, At-Tabi'i Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad. Fudayl ibn Iyad, my brothers, used to be a gangster. He used to be a thug, yeah? We're not speaking about the 21st century wannabes. This guy used to scare people off in Mecca. Very dangerous guy, yeah? Very dangerous, subhanAllah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him, mashallah, one of the beautiful scholars of At-Tabi'in. The companion of the companions. And you have to see something here, my brothers. That when a person used to be a thug or a gangster, and then he left that lifestyle, he is the most keenest out of anybody to make sure of two things. One, you would never know he used to be a thug before. He won't deal with you in a bad way. He won't deal with you in a thug way. He would make sure that he's on point. And the second thing is the most keenest on giving da'wah to everybody. Because he used to be there. He've done this, he's seen that, and he want to make sure that everybody stayed away from it. Yeah? So Fudayl ibn Iyad, rahimahullah, he was a da'wah machine. If you found somebody in the street, he'll make sure that he'll give you da'wah, right? And he stopped somebody. And he said to them, كَمْ حَتَتْ عَلَيْكَ How old are you now? فَقَالَ سَبْتُونَ سَنَةً He said, I'm 60 years old. So look what Fudayl is saying to him. فَقَالَ لَهُ إِذَنْ أَنْتَ مُنْدُ سِدِّينَ سَنَةَ سِيرُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ وَأَنْتَ كُوشِكُ الْقُلُوبِ He said, you've been for 60 years now walking towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you are very close to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're 60 years old, you have white hair, gray beard. But look what he's saying to him. He didn't say to him, Yaqi, you're 60 years old. Fear Allah, look at you. He said to him, for 60 years, you've been walking towards Allah and you're nearly there. Look what happened now. He puts a lot of pressure on the guy, right? That means one of you went for 60 years walking towards Allah. What have you prepared for 60 years? So the guy was afraid, right? He said, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. He said to Allah, we belong unto Allah, we're going to return. So look what Fudayl ibn Iyad, then you're going to get easier. No, no, no. He said, do you know what you mean? What you just said now? أَتَعْلَمُ تَفْسِيرُ مَا تَقُولُ He said, do you know what that means, what you just said now? إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ لَهِ رَجَعُونَ He said, do you know what that means? So the guy was like, no, I didn't know what to say. He said, أَنَا لِلَّهِ وَأَنَا إِلَيْهِ رَجَعُ It means, I belong to Allah, and I am going to go back to Allah. أَنَا لِلَّهِ عَبْدُ وَأَنَا لِلَّهِ رَجَعُ I am a slave to Allah, and I'm definitely going to go back to Him. Indeed, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ لَهِ رَجَعُونَ Indeed, to Allah we belong, and to Allah we're going to return. فَلْيَعْلَمْ Then know, أَنَّهُ مَنْ كَانَ لِلَّهِ عَبْدٌ وَأَنَّهُ لَا بُدِّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعٌ Then know, if you are truly a slave to Allah, and most certainly you're going to go back to Him, فَلْيَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ مَرْضُوفٌ Then know, you're going to be standing into account. You're going to be held to account. وَمَنْ عَلِمَ أَنَّهُ مَرْضُوفٌ فَلْيَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ مَسْئُولٌ And then if you know, you're going to be held to account, then know Allah's going to question you about every single thing you do. Every single thing. That small thing that you do when nobody else is watching, and that big thing when nobody else is watching. That small thing when everybody is watching, and that big thing when you don't care who's watching. Allah's going to ask you about every single thing. وَمَنْ عَلِمَ أَنَّهُ مَسْئُولٌ فَلْيَعُدُّ لِلسُّؤَالِ جَوَابًا And whosoever knows that he's going to be questioned on the day of judgment, then make sure you prepare an answer for these questions. Look what the Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad brought him into. Simple things, but subhanAllah, very dangerous things. So the guy was baffled. He said, وَمَنْ حِيلًا said, so you've put me in a place, I don't know what to do now. So what's the trick, what's the solution to this? قَالَ وَمَنْ حِيلًا قَالَ يَسِيرًا He said, easy man, he said, very easy. He said, yeah, وَمَا هِيَ What is it, man? It's very easy. You put me in a very dangerous spot here. What should I do? And this is where you need to listen up, my brother. He said, أَن تُحْسِنَ فِي مَا بَقِيَ يُغْفَرَ لَكَ مَا مَضَى He said that you make sure from today till the day you die, you perfect the time that has been given to you. You perfect the way you worship Allah. You perfect the way that you spend your time. You perfect the way that you go to your work. Perfect every single thing that Allah gave you. And تُحْسِنَ فِي مَا بَقِيَ That time that is left to you, perfect it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive whatever was past. And how did he know this? Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad, he's not just saying things, yeah? Allah said in the Quran, إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا Where did he know this? Allah said in the Quran, except those who repented and believed they needed to repent, they believed in the wrongdoers, they believed in haram, and they believed in the right ways now, and then they started to prove that belief with actions, Allah will replace their bad deeds with good, and Allah's all merciful and all forgiving. These are the ones, and this is how we got it. But there's a twist. There's a twist to that story, right? He said to him, أَنْتَحْسِرْ بِمَا بَقِيَا يُكْفَرْ لَكَ مَا مَضَى فَإِنْ أَسَأْتَ He said, but if you did wrong things now, but if in what's remaining in your life you did wrong things, أُخِفْتَ بِمَا بَقِيَا وَبِمَا مَضَى He said, but if you do wrong things in what's ever remaining in your life, it could be seconds, it could be minutes, it could be hours, it could be days, years, months, you don't know. If in these small times that's remaining in your life, yeah, you have wronged yourself, then Allah will make sure He will punish you with whatever was remaining or whatever has passed. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم إن الله كان غفورا رحيما فاستغفر My brothers, what we need to understand from today's khutbah, two things that you need to understand, this is what the ulama told us when we used to study with them. They said, make sure when you go to a khutbah, you go to a lesson, you go to a talk, don't just listen, yeah, as if you're listening to, you know, just a recitation of a Quran from a person who has a very nice voice. They don't focus on the meanings of the words, don't focus on the ayat, and what do they mean, or what do they say. Make sure that when you're in a khutbah or in a lesson or a talk, take some benefit, i.e. implement things in your life. So what you need to take away from this, my brother, today, is the question, are you from the people of this dunya, or are you from the people of hereafter? Who are you? And this is where you need to understand, my brother, that the small things that you do when you don't care about them so much, look what Al-Fudayl ibn Ayyad said. He said, whatever Allah gave you in time, whatever is left in your life, you should make sure that you perfect these things. Make sure that whatever is remaining in your life, you perfect them. Because, my brother, when you think that these small minor sins that you do, these small mistakes that you do, are minor mistakes, they're not big deal, then it comes another beautiful saying where it says, the Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said it in a way, and the ulama made it in a simplistic way. They said, لا صغيرة مع إصرار ولا كبيرة مع استغفار. They said to you something profound, and listen to these things carefully. They said, لا صغيرة مع إصرار. There is no minor sins when you insist on doing them every day. There is no minor sins. يعني. Let's say for example, يعني, you smoke, you listen to music, you do something which is haram, but you think it's a minor sin. If this is what you think, and you do them every single day, that minor sin, my brother, becomes a major sin every single day. You know why? Not because of the sin itself, but because of your attitude towards the sin. You're insisting towards sinning against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that kind of attitude and approach becomes a problem. These small minor sins that you think they are small becomes a major sin every single time. So imagine that now. Your attitude towards the sin. Even the attitude towards a sin, because you don't look at how small the sin is, but rather you look at the greatness of the one that you sin against. And this is what Fudayl ibn Ayyad is trying to explain to the guy. For 60 years you were walking towards Allah. What have you prepared to meet Allah with? What's your attitude towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And that is the question you need to ask yourself, my brother. If you are a people of this dunya, if your whole life and time is fixated on only this dunya, then what is it that you're gonna give on the Day of Judgment? What is it gonna represent? What are you gonna present in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That's the first question. Second question is, are you looking at your sins and your bad deeds as a small thing? Hence, you do them every single day and you think it's fine, it's okay. I'll tell you something. This is Al-Fudayl ibn Ayyad. A big, big gangster, used to be a gangster. Used to be a thug, very dangerous man. Saying these words to you, meet every single person that used to be dangerous, come to my hometown in Sicily, in Italy, speak to the wannabes and speak to the actual thugs and see how they used to be before and how they are now. We knew brothers when I used to study in Egypt, subhanAllah, their life beforehand, my brother, wallahi, very dangerous. You meet them, you think, yeah, they were born, yeah, mashallah, like doves. like baby rabbits. MashaAllah, they become sweet and nice. You would never know there used to be bad people before. But wallahi, they used to be very dangerous. Why? They never took their sins in a very simplistic way. They never took it lightly. They made sure that if when they became practicing, when they became Muslim, you would not see these bad things again. So my brothers, make sure of today two things. One, are you from the people of this dunya? Or are you from the people of Al-Akhirah? Two, don't take your sins lightly. From today onwards, make sure that your sins, your life, your time is only fixated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah, the Rasul, he told you, Allah told you in the Quran, the things that I told you to stay away from it completely. The haram, stay away from it completely. And the things that I told you to do, which are good, do as much as you can. Look at the difference now. The haram, stay completely. Stay away, khalas. It's difficult, you have to go cold turkey. If you don't understand, you do understand. You have to go cold turkey. The bad things, go cold turkey. The good things, as much as you can. Allah, this is why the Rasulullah came, if I do my five pillars, this is alright? He said, if you do them, happy days. So the good things, as much as you can, but the haram, cold turkey. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our hearts sincere. And you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the people of Al-Akhirah, not from this dunya. Aminu, aminu, say ameen, my brothers, say ameen. May Allah make us one of those of Al-Akhirah. I can't hear you, my brothers. Ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rectify our deeds. And you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our hearts. And to make our hearts filled with the iman. And to stay away from the haram. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us knowledge of Islam. And to make us one of those who Allah will be happy to see on the day of judgment. And to forgive our sins and the sins of our forefathers. Aqulu qawli hadha wa aqulu salam.
صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.